Hi, it's Paul. So today I'm going to do a two-part video. The first part, I'm going to log into AppStream and get all the software talking to each other. And in the second part, I'm going to do one of the first labs that we have to do in the course. So let's get started. We'll go to Canvas first, and I'll go to the first unit. And right here is AWS AppStream Launch. So I'm going to click on that, and that opens a new window and opens up AppStream. And then you have to log in. Okay, you come to this screen, so click on that. And it comes up with the programs that we have. So it doesn't matter too much what you open first, so click on any one of these. And usually takes about 2 minutes to open. Okay, Factory IO is open. Now I'm gonna open some more programs. So Factory IO, that's our virtual factory, and Studio 5000 Emulate is our virtual PLC. That's what runs our factory. So I'll get both of those guys open. I'm going to open Studio 5000, which is our PLC programming software. So here's Emulate is open, that's our virtual PLC. Here I've got Factory IO, that's our virtual factory. That's where all our lights and buttons and things are going to be. And then here's Studio 5000. I'm just going to open a new project. And when this comes up, I need to change the controller type. The default is this 1756. And I need to use the virtual PLC. That's this guy here. And in slot 2 here is our controller in this virtual PLC. So I'm going to expand Studio 5000 Emulate, and I'm going to select that controller. And for now, I'm just going to call this junk because this is not a file I'm going to save. And location. Well, I don't want it saving on the D drive because that's a location I can't get to later on. So I'll click on Browse. And on this PC, there's my OneDrive and my files in my OneDrive. So I'm just going to save it there on my OneDrive. Okay, click Next. We only have one version of the software. We're on version 33. That's currently the latest. And notice the default here is slot 0. Well, that's where I have a communication card. I need to tell it that my controller is in slot 2. So click that drop down, tell it we're in slot 2, and then we're finished. I have three programs running now. I have my Factory IO, my virtual factory, and I just have no scene in it. I just have an empty shell right now. Here I've got Studio 5000, that's my programming software, and that guy's empty. If I open up my main routine, I've got nothing there. So that's my programming software. And here I have my virtual PLC. Keep in mind that these PLCs of Allen Bradley's were initially designed and developed and released in the 1990s. That's long before Windows existed. And a lot of their architecture is still the same. So it's a pre-Windows type of device. And here we're using Studio 5000, which is a Windows software. And those two can't talk directly to each other. They need a communication software. And we actually use two communication softwares. They're kind of transparent to us, but we have to be aware of them. One is, if I click on communications and go Who Active, it brings up an Allen Bradley software, Rockwell software, called Factory Talk. So we're going to use this software for Studio 5000 to talk to our PLCs. That's exactly how we do it in the lab and in the real world. So there's that software. But there's another one that we need to use. And if we go over to our list of applications, there's RS Links Classic. And this is kind of a babysitting communication software. If we don't have this software running, a lot of times the virtual PLC runs into communication problems. When this is running, it continuously scans the hardware, and any minor faults, it automatically fixes them. So it's kind of our nanny program. Okay, so it's open, and I'm going to minimize it because I don't have to do anything with it. I just have to have it running. All right. Now I want Studio 5000 to talk to my controller. That's that guy in slot 2. So I'm going to go communication, who active, and expand the backplane. And there in slot 2 is my controller. So this software has found this controller. And I'll go online. Okay, I've got green bars there. So that tells me that Studio 5000 is talking to this controller. Notice it's showing that I have a battery fault, and we don't need to worry about that. That's not going to stop us. If it was a problem, the RS Link software that's running here in the background would go in and fix it for us. So we're going to ignore that for now. Okay, so those two are talking. We still need to have Factory IO talk to that controller. So I'm going to just open a scene, and I'll have to go to drivers and tell it that we're using Allen Bradley Logix 5000. And now I need to configure that. So when I go to configuration, by the way, don't check this auto connect, that'll mess you up in the future. So the host, I need to tell it where this controller is. And this is not going to be the right IP address because that's from last time. It changes every time. I need to find the IP address. And to do that, I use one of our communication softwares. So I can go communication, who active again. That brings up factory talk links. And I'll just expand the Ethernet here. And I can see it's 198.19.10.225. So I need 198.19.10.225. I also need to make sure that it knows that the controller's in slot 2. And I'll go back and I'm going to click connect. And I have a green light, and it sees that bool in 0 is good, and it's missing these two because I never put them in Studio 5000. But now I'll go one more back, and I'll put this into run mode. And now I have all the software talking to each other. So Factory IO talks to that controller. Studio 5000 talks to that controller. Factory IO and Studio 5000 can never talk to each other. There's no way for them to communicate. All they can do is they can both talk to that controller. And of course, for Studio 5000 to talk to that controller, it needs communication software. So those are the programs you need, and that's how you get everything talking to each other. In the next video, I'm going to show doing the first lab. So I'm going to download a file out of Canvas and import it into here, and we're going to get going with it. Okay, thanks.